everyone and welcome back to my channel. Myself Dr. Surbisani. Hope you are doing great. Now today's video is on request and everyone is waiting for this video because today we are going to talk about the solved MCQs of the INSET November 2016, yani ki 2016 INSET November paper, or we can say the AIIMS PG paper, that too of the November of 2016, and that too with solution. So please, it's my request that you can watch this video till the end, as there are lots of queries regarding the past papers and there are the recall PDFs only, not the complete PDF, just like the 10 years PDF set we have for the NEET MDS. We can't have the same for the this year also, like for INSET. So that's why it's better to make a long videos regarding the past papers with solution for the INSET, because that will help you to even remember. The first question on your screen: which of the following nerve supply tonsil? Option A, greater palatine. Option B, facial. Option C, glossopharyngeal. And option D, lesser palatine. So what do you think, what will be the right answer to this question? See, here the right answer is option C, that is glossopharyngeal. Now why glossopharyngeal is the right answer? Because the tonsillar nerves are basically derived from the tonsillar plexus, right? And tonsillar plexus are formed by the cervical nerve 9 and cervical nerve 10, right? That is the vagus and cervical nerve 9 and cervical nerve 10, and from the pharyngeal plexus of the nerves. So jo tonsillar area hai pura, that is formed by the tonsillar branches of the maxillary nerve as well as the glossopharyngeal nerve. The fibers from the maxillary nerve are passing through, they do not synapse in, they are just passing through it, the fibers of the maxillary nerve. They do not synapse in, the fibers of the maxillary nerve, they do not synapse in, they just pass through the pterygopalatine ganglion, followed by that they are distributed through the lesser petrosal nerve, and which forms the plexus that is known as the circulus tonsillar plexus, right? Or we can say they form the plexus known as the circulus tonsillaris. More question pop up, that what is circulus tonsillaris? From the tonsils they form the plexus which is known as the circulus tonsillaris, followed by together with the tonsillar branches of the glossopharyngeal nerve, nerve fibers from the plexus are also distributed to the soft palate and the region of the isthmus, that is the oropharyngeal isthmus. So the tympanic branch of the glossopharyngeal nerve basically supply the tonsil. So that's why out of the four options, the right answer is option C, that is the glossopharyngeal nerve. See the question. Second question on your screen: during facial growth, groove between the lateral nasal process and maxillary process give rise to option A, nasolacrimal duct, option B, nasal nostril, option C, remain as a groove, option D, it will fuse. So what do you think, what will be the right answer to this question? Option A, that is the nasolacrimal duct. Now nasolacrimal duct is derived from the, or we can say that it is originate from the nasolacrimal groove, and that too after the 6 week of the fertilization. They basically extend from the medial end of the developing eye to the primitive stomatodium, right? And the grooves between the lateral nasal process and the maxillary process are present on each side. The duct connect the nasolacrimal sac with the nasal cavity, and they function to drain the lacrimal secretions from the eye to there, right? Now let's see the third question on your screen. It is the image based question. Identify the area highlighted by the arrow in the below histopathology site of condylar cartilage. Option A is fibrous, option B proliferative, option C hypertrophic zone, and option D calcified cartilage. So what do you think, what will be the right answer to this image based question? So here the right answer is option B, that is the proliferative layer. See, so there are four types of the layer. One is the fibrous layer, which is the uppermost layer. Second is the proliferative layer. Third one is the chondrocytic cell layer. Fourth one is the hypertrophic cell layer. So first of all, we talk about each and every layer in detail so as it will remember you, right, very well. And its mnemonic is the FB pe chale jao na. So that is F B, B ki jagah P, F B pe. So F B pe chale jao, that means C se chondrocystic layer of the cells, right? R means hypertrophic cell layer. So this is the mnemonic, F B pe chale jao na, theek hai. So if you didn't remember the layer, so then you can remember by this mnemonic very well. Followed by the first layer is the fibrous layer, is the uppermost superficial layer. Basically, it provides the protection to the underlying cartilaginous layer, right? So, this layer is not related deeper to the chondrogenic differentiation, right? It is the superficial layer of the condylar cartilage only. This is the proliferative layer, which is the answer to this question. That is the image based question. Basically, the proliferative layer, as a name suggests, there is the process of proliferation takes place in the proliferative layer. Basically, it is divided into two parts. One is the upper sub layer and second one is the lower sub layer. So, based upon the cellular morphology, that where it is present, the proliferative layer has been divided into two parts. One is the upper sub layer and second one is the lower sub layer. Now what is the upper sub layer? It is the polymorphic cell layer, which is irregular and having the irregular polygonal cells in it with the rounded nuclei, right, which is densely packed. On the other hand, the lower sub layer, which is known as the flattened cell layer, right, where the flattened cells are oriented with the long axil parallel to the articular surface. One unique characteristic of the condylar cartilage is that the cells which are present in the proliferative layer have multi-lineage potential and can differentiate into chondrocytes, osteoblasts, that is the osteochondral progenitors, and more differentiated cells which are committed to becoming the chondrocytes, that is the chondroprogenitors, that means the progenitor cells are there, right? Followed by that, the third layer is the chondrocystic cell layer. Again, as a name suggests, there might be the chances of the presence of the chondrocytes, right? So, chondrocystic cell layer contains the chondrocytes at various stage of the layer, or we can say at the various stage of the maturation. The ECM in this layer has been increased in the areas and shows the hematoxylinphilic staining and metachromatic staining with the taurine blue, indicating the active deposition of the cartilage characteristics matrices. Synthetic activity of the collagens, proteoglycans and sulfated glycoaminoglycans peak in this layer. Layer that is the hypertrophic cell layer. Hypertrophy, as the name suggests, the terminal differentiation stage of the chondrogenic lineage is required for the replacement of the cartilage with bone. That is the endochondral ossification when there is the replacement of the cartilage with bone. Sensing hypertrophy, chondrocyte increases in volume, initiate the calcification of the surrounding matrix, and they are invaded by the bone marrow vasculature. They are invaded by the bone marrow vasculature, which is accompanied by the chondroclastic and the odontogenic and osteogenic precursor cells. The calcified cartilaginous matrix is degenerated by differentiated chondroclast and newly selected bones matrix, which is deposited onto the cartilage remnants. In the hypertrophic cell layer, although synthetic activity of the matrix synthesis is decreased, phenotypic transition from type 2 to type 10 collagen occurs. The hyperosites are generally believed to undergo the apoptosis, but some researchers have suggested that some survive and transform into the osteogenic cells. Fourth question, that is again the image based question, which is shown on your screen, and the options are option A, M arch appliance, option B, W arch appliance, option C, the transpalatal arch, and option D, the lingual palatal arch. So what do you think, what will be the right answer to this question? See here, the right answer is option B, that is the W arch appliance is there in the image, because the W arch appliance is used for the expansion of the upper arch and lower teeth, unlike the RPE, that is the rapid palatal expander. It does not expand the whole arch, but instead it widens the particular teeth, one teeth in the arch, right? Followed by, it only widens the teeth in the arch, right? Not the complete arch. The W arch is bounded to the permanent upper molars and it is activated prior to the placement and will expand at a gradual rate. The W arch is the simplest form of the W expander, which is the design expander. That is, the W expander is the design expander. Expander is the design expander, which is available, and it is the simplest form of the W expander, right? Now that's all about the today's video. Hope you like this video, then hit the like button. If you still have any query, you can drop me the mail which is shown on your screen, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new on my channel. If you still have any query, you can drop me the mail which is shown on your screen, and don't forget to follow me on my Instagram ID which is shown on your screen. Thank you for watching.